Welcome back everyone, today we're going to look at the classic Mortal Kombat 1 and its proposed minimum requirement, which is Intel i5-6600 or AMD Ryzen 3 3100 or Ryzen 5 2600, 8GB of RAM, NVIDIA GeForce GTX 980 and or AMD Radeon RX 470 and or Arc A750. Welcome to Respawn PC, I'm Dunk, let's dive in. I do not have the exact minimum requirement. Instead of the i5-6600, I have an i5-6500, both 4-core, 4-thread, but one at 3.3 GHz and one at 3.2 GHz. So we have 1 MHz difference, which isn't much of a difference. For the other difference, I have a GTX 980 Ti, not the GTX 980. Again, the Ti give a little bit more performance, but let's say it even out with the lower performing CPU. 8GB of memory, I have a 2x4GB in dual channel, and for the storage, I have a SSD. It doesn't specify SSD, HDD, or NVMe, so I'm going to start with the SSD. I will come out later with the video differencing SSD, NVMe, and HDD. But for now, let's start with the SSD. So NetherRealm Studio didn't say their minimum requirement is 720p, 1080p, 1440p. We don't know, so we're going to try to gauge at 1080p. I'll make a video later at 720p for the real minimum requirement. So 1080p low settings, 60fps, probably going to be higher. I didn't plug to a higher frame rate monitor, so I maxed out at 60. Not buggish, not stutterish, not laggish, run perfectly. I'm going to pop up a bit the settings. Now, as you can see, the menu for the graphics is rather thin to non-existent. Your choice is the resolution, the graphic presets, V-Syncs, the FPS limit, and upscaling. Nothing else you can do there. So we're just going to jump to preset medium, or whatever that imply. Now, as you can see, the menu for the graphics is rather thin to non-existent. Your choice is the resolution, the graphic presets, V-Syncs, the FPS limit, and upscaling. Nothing else you can do there. So we're just going to jump to preset medium, or whatever that imply. Now, as you can see, the FPS in the menu and in the cinematic are capped at 30fps, and I didn't find where you can remove that cap of 30fps. When in game, fighting, you reach the 60fps, and every time there's a small cutscene for every combo or whatever you do, it drops to 30fps, then back to 60. And again, the 980 Ti with the proposed minimum requirement is literally killing it. In my book, minimum requirement is playing at 720p low 30fps or 1080p low 30fps, if it's not the FPS game. Here you can see a bloody example of 30fps while in combat, then back to 60fps when the cutscene ends. I really hope they remove that cinematic FPS cap, because sometimes it makes the game stutter a little bit, and let the GPU manage the cutscene itself instead of loading one. So maybe dropping the FPS by itself because the GPU is running, maybe drop at 40, 50, but not forcing it to go to 30. Now let's change the only graphical preset we can change, preset high, and see how it fares. Maybe we're going to finally reach the minimum requirement by the book, at least my book, of 30fps and at 1080p. For the cinematic, again, you still cap at 30fps, and when the combat starts, we reach again the 60fps. So this is literally not the minimum requirement for this game. Can play with way lower equipment. That will be the next video. Real minimum requirement to play Mortal Kombat 1. And as you can see, I'm not even using the 8GB of memory that they require for minimum requirement. And for the CPU and the GPU, none of them is reaching 100%. None of them is bottlenecking the other one. The next video is really going to be fun to make, to find out the real minimum requirement to play Mortal Kombat 1. Because obviously, those minimum requirement, proposed minimum requirement, are all wrong. For sure, we're going to stick with DirectX 12 because the game seems to only support that version of DX. I really can't wait to make it look like grainy like Mortal Kombat 2. I'm happy to have made this video. See you next time on the real minimum requirement or loading on HDD, SSD, NVMe. Subscribe.